never should have come. Kaviri's stonework here.
We've got to get this bridge down. These pillars must have something to do with it.
Yes, these are Akaviri symbols. Here, let's see. You have the symbol for king and warrior, and of course the symbol for dragonborn. That's the one that appears to have a sort of arrow shape pointing downward at the bottom. Yes, that's it. The symbol on the middle pillar.
Whatever you did, you worked. Let's see what those old blades left. Esbern's right. Look like pressure plates.
Be careful.
Look safe now. Let's move.
Yes, I think we must be close to the entrance.
Remarkably well preserved. Ah, here's the blood seal, another of the lost Akaviri arts, no doubt triggered by, well, blood. Your blood, Dragonborn. Look here. You see how the ancient blades revered Riemann Cyrodiil? This whole place appears to be the end of the Akaviri blade. Mysterious, as I recall. Fascinating. Original Akaviri bas-reliefs, almost entirely intact. Amazing. You can see how the Akaviri craftsmen were beginning to embrace the more flowing Nordic style.
We're here for Alduin's wall, right, Esbern?
Yes, of course. We'll have more time to look around later. Let's see what's up ahead. Tor's bones. Here it is. Alduin's Wall, so well preserved. Huh? I've never seen a final example of early second era Kaviri sculpture in relief.
Esmond, we need information, not a lecture on artists.
Yes, yes. Let's see what we have. Here is Alduin. This panel goes back to the beginning of time, when Alduin and the dragon cult ruled Taurus Skyrim. Here, the humans rebelled against their dragon overlord, the legendary Dragon War. Alduin's defeat is the centerpiece of the war. You see, here is fallen from the sky. The Nord Tongs, masters of the voice, are arrayed.
So does it show how they defeated him? Isn't that why we're here?
Ah, patience. The Akaviri were not a straightforward people. Everything is couched in allegory, mythic symbol. Yes, yes. This here, coming from the mouths of the Nord heroes, this is the Akaviri symbol for shout. But there's no way to know what shout is meant.
You mean they used a shout to defeat Alduin? You're sure?
Oh, yes. Presumably something rather specific to dragons. Or even Alduin himself. Remember, this is where they recorded all the news of Alduin.
So we're looking for a shout, then. Damn it. Have you ever heard of such a thing? A shout that can knock a dragon out of the sky? You're probably right. I was hoping to avoid having to involve them in this, but it seems we have no choice. If they had their way, you do nothing but sit up on their mountain with them and talk to the sky, or whatever it is they do. The Greybeards are so afraid of power that they won't use it. Think about it. Have they tried to stop the Civil War, or done anything about Alduin? No. And they're afraid of you, of your power. Trust me, there is no need to be afraid. Think of Tiber Septim. Do you think he'd have founded the Empire if he'd listened to the Greybeards? Only if you don't know how to use it. All the great heroes have had to learn to use their power. Those that shrank from their destiny. Well, you've never heard of them, have you? And there are the villains, those that misused their power. There's always a choice, and there's always a risk. But if you live in fear of what might go wrong, you'll end up doing nothing. Like the Greybeards up on their mountain.
Right. Good thing they've already let you into their little cult. Not likely they'd help Esbern or me if we came calling. We'll look around Skyhaven Temple and see what else the old Blades might have left for us. It's a better hideout than I could have hoped for. Talos guard you.
Look here, in the third panel. The prophecy which brought the Akaviri to Tamriel in the first place, in search of the Dragonborn. Here are the Akaviri, the Blades. You see their distinctive longswords. Now they need their ancient mission fulfilled, as the last Dragonborn contends with Alduin at the end of time. Are you paying attention, Delphine? You might learn something of our own history.
What is it? The Thalmor hunted us down, remember? It wasn't exactly great for recruitment. But we have a headquarters of a sort now. We will rebuild the Blades. Someday. If you find anyone you think would make a good recruit, I can certainly take a look at them. Remember, though, being a Blade is a lifelong commitment. Their loyalty has to be with us once they're in.
I know the prophecy by heart. Once all Blades knew it, when misrule takes its place at the eight corners of the world, when the brass tower walks and time is reshaped, when the thrice blessed fail and the red tower trembles, when the dragonborn ruler loses his throne and the white tower falls, when the snow tower lies sundered, kinless, bleeding, the world eater wakes and the wheel turns upon the last dragonborn.
Well, I'm gonna look around some more, see what the old Blades left for us.
Yeah, that's an excellent question. Who knows what other.
To wonder, what does the Dragonborn do once he's summoned by the Greybeards?
Thank you.
I'm Gorz's assistant. I help him support.
Mayo, the finest weapons and armor. Let me know. Need a new blade? Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision. Thank you. I'll be sure to put it to good use. Need anything? How about some armor? Don't bother with the time. Use it.
Business to college majors having a place like Sorthon anyway. It's a place for Lord Death. Out of my way, outsider. The Forsworn have been spotted to the north near Bruker's Leap Redoubt.